Machine Magazine. It is the 4th of July. Happy 4th of July. Thank you. I know everybody's relaxing and having a good time, but hey, work still got to keep going, and we still got to give you all this wonderful content and information with Talk Tuesday, Machine Magazine. And guess who is back? Trey Chapman. What's up, Trey?
And what's going on?
You, man.
What's going on? It's good to be back.
All right. Hey, it's Sammy.
Good. It's good that the fans love me. It's good that the fans love Sheen Magazine. It's great that we number one on stand. It feels good, but we right back here at the house, back at the mansion. We back right at the pool going on to our left. You can't see it, but I know you can hear it, though. You know, I might go for a swim on Talk Tuesday next time. But hey, tell me what went on last week.
Last week we had Asia Pars, which of Innovative Hair Designs, and we also talked about the HBCU initiative.
Yep.
So tell me about that, Trey Chapman. Did you find out how much we made or what we raised?
Well, right now, you know, we did it last year, but it started in August. And we're going to be on the road for the rest of the month with Talk Tuesday, raising money. And you know, next year, giving away money to all the HBCUs, making sure they stay open. You know what? And, you know, we did a lot of things for HBCUs. Like, check our records. When you talk to South Carolina State, for all you people that won the state, what we give them, about $60,000?
No more.
We gave them more than that?
Yeah.
Hey, HBCU tour ain't no joke. We giving away money to people in our community, black people that's going to HBCU to make sure that they become successful in life and do more than they thought they could even do. Machine Magazine, CFI, Pure Hairdresser, we're using Nairobi. We're giving back to the community. We're doing it all to the max.
Absolutely. And you know, it's good seeing our culture increase, because I've been here, you know, some years now, and I've seen the progress, and it's mm-hmm. so wonderful. We just have to keep increasing and be better. And you know, we have none other than QL from 96
the
Block.
What's going on?
Hey, good to have you here.
I'm excited to be here. I just want to say, I'm happy to see what you guys are doing for HBCUs. You know, I went to HBCU,
yeah,
and to see, you know, we have different local companies that's partnered up, and you know, that able to give back to our community, to HBCUs. It's just an amazing feeling. It really is,
and I enjoyed being at HBCU. I played a lot, had some fun, but there's nothing like an HBCU.
Man, shout out to Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated, Zeta Gamma Boys College, the best HBCU in South Carolina. Uh-huh. Most definitely.
All right.
Okay. But hey, man, you know, since working with 96 The Block, can you tell us a little bit about your backpack initiative?
Well, I actually started a nonprofit organization called Project 100. And it's really interesting. So a couple of years ago, I actually had like this vision that came to me when I mentioned to my mom, but because of life happening at the time, we wasn't really able to move forward with it.
Yeah.
So just recently, I sat with the founder of Sly Nation, Curtis Dawkins, big shout out to him, and I just expressed to him, you know, the things that I wanted to do in the city of Spartanburg, because, you know, what's happening is we have, you know, all of our surrounding cities like Greenville and Simpsonville, just all these bigger cities. Everybody's always pointing to these communities, but Spartanburg has been abandoned for so long, and I want to get back to my community. So we sat together and we put together Project 100, which basically is going to be a nonprofit organization that is going to serve as a lighthouse to the community. And our very first event is going to be the Project 100 Back to School Fair, and it's going to be August 12th, and we'll be giving away 100 backpacks filled with school supplies, and it's going to be a day of fun and just a laughter and just, you know, just a big community event for like the kids and the youth and all that stuff.
That's great, because, you know, a lot of people, man, they don't, like, I don't have kids, but I've been, you know, in a middle school or elementary school,
right,
where I got to get school supplies, because, you know, the list come in the mail.
Right, you know, that long list.
You can get a backpack, and it might be worth $100.
Right.
But just pencils and what brings you in, crayons, papers, notebooks, and you got to get the binder with the dividers in it and all that. So, the Project 100 and backpack that.
Well, okay, so, Project 100 is an organization as a whole. Our first event is going to be the back to school fair. Then our second event, we're going to do like a turkey drive. We're going to give away 100 turkeys during Thanksgiving.
Oh, wow, that's great. 100 turkeys.
100 turkeys.
Where will they be given?
Yeah, well, we're thinking we're going to do it in Spartanburg, and then after we finish with Spartanburg, we're going to, you know, advance out to, you know, towns like Taylor's and Easton and Greenville, just all the different small cities.
Yeah.
Okay, but 100 turkeys in Spartanburg, what location?
We haven't got that location yet, but as the details come, you know, I will keep Sheen Magazine
updated
so you guys know
exactly
all that good stuff. But yes, we just really want to be a lighthouse to the community and give back to the community.
But I see a play too, man, because, you know, when Walmart started, They started on the outskirts of the community and then accidentally came inside.
They did.
So what you're saying right now, if I start around Spartanburg, well, it's on the city anyway, with Taylor's and all the outside of Greenville, man, you can do, but when the outside of the city love you, man, you come in and take over.
Project 100 could be a nationwide thing like Sheen Magazine.
Yeah,
you know?
It can.
Oh, we got quiet.
So just tell me, man, how can people get involved with Project 100?
So we have different drop-off locations, and I'll leave you my social media plug so everybody can follow me on social media and the Project 100 Facebook page. If you just search us at Project 100 on Facebook, you can see all of our drop-off locations. But we have different drop-off locations throughout the Spartanburg area, and you can leave things like backpacks, pencils, paper, color, whatever it is that you have and you want to give back. Mm-hmm. We're, you know, having that open to everybody.
Oh, that's good.
Yes, ma'am.
What made you come up with this?
Well, I was just, you know, I hear so many community leaders saying, you know, they want to get back to the community, or they do this, and this, but you don't really see too many people doing things.
Mm-hmm.
And I just really felt for my Spartanburg community, and I do so many things in Greenville, I said, well, let me go back to Spartanburg, let me get back to my community, and to, you know, the neighborhoods that I grew up in. And I just really put it to work, and I'm just excited to have people around me that actually supports my vision and actually want to go forward with it.
That's good.
Yes,
but I see you on the social media a lot.
Yes,
and 96. How do you enjoy being at 96 the block?
Oh my God. I love it. Big shout out to Steve Center Property, man.
Hello, Steve.
Yes.
What's up, Steve?
So listen, you know, I actually worked at another station in Greenville for about 2 years. Kelly Mack was my mentor, and that was before she moved off to in Indianapolis and all that good stuff. And you know, I just stayed under her leadership at Elroy Smith. And I moved off and I did a radio show back at school. It was called The President's Drive Home, and it was playing oldies music and all that good stuff. And
I love oldies music.
Well, I wasn't really a big fan of oldies music, but I had to really, you know, step into it because that was my job. But I enjoyed it, and you know, with just having all the experience behind my belt working with Watch Fox out of Columbia.
Uh-huh.
And I just really, you know, went full force into radio. So I was at this one station for 2 years. The block reached out to me and said, hey, I want to bring you over to the team. And it's really interesting how God works, because when I first got there, I only had one shift, and that was Sundays from 2 to 7. And I was kind of in the middle of whether I wanted to go or not, but I knew that was the place where he was leading me to. And it went from that, and 3 weeks later, my boss sat me down and was like, hey, I got another shift for you. So then I ended up having 5 shifts a week.
Wow.
At the block. And then it went from that to doing 10 shifts a week. So now I'm doing 96 for the block, and I'm also on that personality for 93.7.
Wow, that's amazing. Well, as long as you do it from the heart, you enjoy it, and your intentions are good, everything should work out perfectly. I want to send shout outs to Courtney Clark at 108 Praise, and also my MBN Channel 4 for being supporting us. And you can also see Facebook, our Sheen Talk Live on those in those areas. You can see us also at Sheen Talk Live Radio. YouTube. The producer trying to tell me something, so my mind is completely off.
Show them the new issue of Sheen Magazine.
Okay, sorry.
Oh, yes, amazing.
Yes, amazing. The new issue of Sheen Magazine. Make sure you pick it up. Where can we pick it up, Trey?
You can pick it up. In Walgreens, Walmart, Books a Million, all that. Just make
everywhere.
Sure you, everywhere. Make sure you go and get you a copy. You know who on the front. We know Ghost in Jail. You know she working it. You know he gon' get out. So we gonna wait till Sunday, because that's what we got on the front. You know what's up. So
make sure you pick your copy of She Magazine up. We wanna. I also wanna let everybody know that I'm signed to be on a reality show, Bosses Unplugged. So,
I just saw that this morning. I shared on my Facebook page.
We'll see how long. Thank you. How long that lasts, everybody. Please make sure you support us, Bosses Unplugged. And so we'll be giving you the details in the days to come. So let's see, they might want me to cut up a little bit. let's see, what else? Oh, so also make sure that they have your information so that they can get in touch with you.
Oh yes, you guys can follow me on social media on Facebook. That's Quan Q. Ellison. I have a friend page and a like page. Now, our friend page is filling up. So if I do reach the 5,000 mark, you guys can go like my page on Quan Q. Ellison. And also follow me on 96 through the block. So Monday through Thursdays from 10 until 12 p.m., 12 a.m., and then on Sundays I'm on from 2 until 7 o'clock.
Okay, you got a number or anything you might want to give them?
Well, yeah, most definitely. 864-202-3181. You guys can give me a call if you guys want to help out with Project 100 or if you want some more information about Project 100. And you can also send us an email at project100spartanburg@gmail.com.
Exactly. And what I want to say, look at my man QL. look at Sheen Magazine. Look at CFI. A lot of people say they want to help you. A lot of people say they want to give back to their community. A lot of people talk about how they should impact their community, but is they going to do it?
Right.
Yes, they going to do it.
Exactly.
Do it.
Don't just talk about it. Be about it.
Yes, look at my man. Please support Sheen Magazine. Yes, please, man. Like, matter of fact, I was just on Instagram. The celebrities have really been showing you guys love. Drake and Michelle.
Reposted.
Erica Campbell. She actually has a huge Sheen Magazine poster inside her studio. Out in Dallas, Texas.
Uh-huh.
So, man, like,
well, we went out there to see her, and she was on the front cover.
Yes, she was. She still has inside the studio. Uh-huh. So every time she's on live, everybody gets to see it. So I'm excited for you guys. Being that we're all from the same hometown, the same area, and just to see you guys doing so well. The Chapman Foundation, all that good stuff, and I'm just excited.
Thank you. Well, you know, you have to work together.
Right.
You can't have any envy and jealousy because it don't work. All the stuff that you put out comes back to you. So whatever you put out there, you actually putting it out there for yourself.
Right.
So those of you who are envious, jealousy, and just got some hate, let it go. Because you put them to yourself.
Right.
And you know, we got the water running out here, the fountains are running, so I hope everybody has been able to hear us this evening, because we're just chilling today. We came home and had Talk Tuesday here at the house today, so we could have
at the mansion.
Enjoyable
this
time.
This is a beautiful home.
We appreciate
that.
Home. Yeah.
Thank you. So everybody, enjoy your 4th of July. Have a great time. It's a little windy out here, so our sign just fell back.
And don't forget, go get the latest issue of Sheen Magazine. Some stories everywhere. Please go support. Please go support.
Sammy, we miss you. We love you. We'll see you this week. Make sure you get here on time so we can get some stuff going. I know you're smiling funny right about now. Trey, you got anything else to say?
Before we sign off, you know, that's really about it. But with the magazine, you know, we the last Mohicans to do it.
Mm-hmm.
We the last ones left in the game, you know. Everybody else selling out. But we still here, still doing it for the community. And with that being said, I holler at y'all later.
Happy 4th of July.
Happy 4th. Be safe. Have fun. Don't eat too much.